What's up guys, this is MechaRaptor, also known as Success Patella, and welcome to part 7 of my Croc 2 walkthrough series. Last time, I killed the bosses of the second world and I gave you a little introduction of the third world by making some ginger soda for this king right here. Holy crap, Fred's lagged a little bit. Hopefully it'll be alright. So, we're gonna do some more levels, but first, as usual, I'm gonna get some more stuff. First, I gotta check my backpack. Yeah, I only got one clockwork gobbo. Thank you for this information, Gabo. But, yeah. Also, this door is very buggy. I don't know why. Hello. You can actually give me a blue booster. Yep, that's what I'm gonna need. And I'm also gonna need a green booster. We're getting fancy now today. We're gonna get some more, some more boosters to buy. And I need one clockwork Gabo, but I know of myself, I'm gonna need two. I just gotta need to. Everything so far has been going well with the clockwork gobos, but I know I'm gonna fuck up sooner or later. Anyways, we're gonna do some levels I like to call the... Well, let that gobo actually introduce it. Racing car wheels. These are the racing car wheels levels of hell. Pretty much. You're gonna see. So this is the first... level what we're gonna do in the third world. Oops. That was a boo-boo. That promise, that's a lot of promise for the next upcoming videos, I guess. Or just this playthrough. Still want to do a decent run of it. That's my suggestion. Anyways. The objective of these levels is not really to save a gobbo. Or to, you know, whatever. Just to do anything. To save him. No, you actually have to get some racing car wheels. That's the whole objective of the game. Right now, we're looking at a barricaded door, which is quite unique because we haven't seen this before. So we're gonna have to take another path. Oh, here's another door. But holy crap, this one has a lock on it. So it seems like we have a little bit of a dilemma. But fortunately, there is also a third door, which we can actually enter. So it's a little bit of a puzzle solving. It's not really that linear, but it isn't really that, you know, rocket science either. It's just, you gotta go from A to B, and B unlocks C, and you know, and that's that kind of stuff. So actually, you should get from A to C, but you need to go through B first. Gotta make this thing a lot more complicated than it is. So, the level isn't really linear, but the objective is pretty straightforward. You need to get some racing cartwheels. I'm gonna tell you now that there are two wheels hidden in this level. So there are two that we need to get here, and there are two that we need to get in the other level that I'm gonna do today. So it's a little bit tricky. I'm just oh wait, holy crap! I actually forgot to get the key. That was kind of stupid. Yeah, now I'm gonna get myself even more derping herping. Jesus, I'm gonna get my ass whooped today if I'm derping like this. Anyways, yeah, we're gonna get myself the key. Can't believe I forgot the key. I mean, I was talking about locks and level design from A to C and B to C and ABCs and whatever. And I forgot the damn key. How the hell am I supposed to advance if I didn't get the key? That was really derpish of me. I'm sorry, guys. Anyways. Yes, this is a little bit tricky. This is a little bit tricky jumping. They really expect you to, like, anticipate the jumps a little bit more. So, is this familiar from the Roger Rand and levels? You know? Hopping the platforms here and there. Anyways, the first crystal. Now we see a clockwork gobble plate. Do you need it? No. There is only 17 crystals and a heart to be found. So it's not really worth it. It's only worth it to be here just for, you know, the crystal. So yeah, I've actually done a practice run on these levels. And, yeah, it's kind of tough. They're really tough. They're tough in the way that there are some things which are really new and unique. But they are also extremely annoying, difficult. Or they even surprise you, you know? Even a gamer like me. I'm not really a hardcore gamer, but, you know, I have a bit of experience with this game. I'm still surprised with some things in this level. So, yeah. Anyways, this is the long walk of the bridge. And then we see a spinning wheel And yeah, this is the wheel that we're gonna get. There are four of them. They always stay in your inventory for some reason. It's not really that you can use them, so why is this even in your inventory? I guess it's just to keep track of how many wheels you have in case you forgot one or whatever, you know. But those four wheels are essential in order to actually complete your quest, you know, to complete the game and stuffs. Okay. Blue booster, do you need it? Nope, there's only a box of five crystals and a heart hidden in there. And it's not really needed. So, again, we're gonna save ourselves some more crystals just by not using the items that we need. Okay, so you can take this path, or it can be a little cheater and can go take this path. And then you think, holy crap, there are more boxes and more stuffs and whatnot. And there's a door over there, and there's another door over there with a key in it. I mean, holy crap, Lux. That's a lot of alternate paths you can take. Yeah, I'm gonna admit, it's a complex level design that we have here. Like, you can get lost in here if you really don't pay attention too much. Anyways, I'm gonna take this path. This is the path I like to take. You could do it another way. You could actually go... I think this is anti-clockwise. You can go clockwise, you can also go anti-clockwise. And holy crap, that's the second time again that I've been hit by one of these dudes. I guess I don't really like him. So, you probably think, well, just jump in there. It's nothing that can go wrong. You know what? Since I'm being such a derp today, I'm going to take the safe route and just do this. So now we got the second crystal. And they really want you to actually, you know, if you really want to explore, you gotta pay. I mean, there are some really nasty jumps in there. Like that one, I think you have to stomp. I tried without stomping. I hit the lava. I was sad. Some jumps, they are pretty tricky. You know, they really want you to step up your game. Like the game is stepping up its game. Anyways, another locked door. I'm gonna call it Path D or whatever. But we have to go outside and get ourselves another key. Finally, one AKO and one of these guys. So, just made that jump. Another blue booster? Yup, we're gonna need that one. We're gonna need that blue booster. There we go, there's a beginner strap! Oh! But I made it. For a crystal, that was just the only reason why we had to do it. Now look at this. Skeletons of prehistoric dinosaurs, I guess. I think it's a little bit offensive to show this to Croc, but then again, who am I? Okay, fucked up platforms. These platforms are kinda buggy. Now you probably think you could just jump over there right now. Nope, you have to time it. That's the secret. As a kid, I'm such an impatient guy that I didn't really want to do it, and I was just stomping in the lava until I get to that box. But no, you really have to take your time, plan it all out, and then hop over to the other ones. Then you can use the box, and once you're going back, you can actually take those platforms, because the developers of the game think, hey, these things were actually kind of stupid, and I agree on it. Look at this, velociraptors. Yeah, dinosaurs and stuffs. And you probably think, holy crap, this is an epic fight. This is because the velociraptors don't die in one hit. Like, I hit them once, they get a bit stunned, and then they go into primal rage mode. And again, you have to hit them twice, very fast. So I'm losing a lot of hit points, but this is just to show you all that the enemies are a bit of a derp. In the way that they're actually stronger. And oh my god, this is the third time already I get hit by one of these guys. Give me the key. Ugh, annoying. Anyways, you see those crystals? That's a pretty bitchy place to get them, huh? Yeah, you really need to, like, if you really want those crystals, you gotta do some tricky jumping, you know, from platform to platform. Kind of annoying, but, you know, there is one crawler crystal up there, so, yeah, we need to do it. That's the fourth one. Just one more to go, and we can get ourselves the Golden Gabo obstacle course. The first Golden Gabo of this third world. Pretty excited to actually snatch it, if it actually works, because I think at this rate, the way I'm playing right now, Yeah, I don't think it's gonna really help a whole lot. Because, god damn it, I'm losing a lot of hit points here and there. It's not good because I still have another world to do. Damn it. I'm not gonna get 100 crystals out of this level, so I don't get full life. So, huh. Okay, I'm gonna take it easy. There we go. Take your time, just like in the ice world. Just take my time and everything will be alright. So we got the key. Can open this door now. So whoopity freaking do. And then another long bridge. And there's another wheel there. So we're gonna get our second wheel. And there's another crystal up there, hidden. Not really hidden, you could see it from far away. And we got ourselves an obstacle course. I hope I will actually manage to do this obstacle course correctly. Like without derping much, because I am really scared. Anyways, this fireball is a bitch. I'm gonna wait for it. You just run. This one is pretty easy. Just walk over it when you have to. This one is a little bit annoying because there's a curve in there. This one is the very last one. You can easily just whoop and then just get, yes, get the gobbo. Number 11. I'm happy. Whew. At least that went right. Okay. So, where are we now? Holy crap, we're actually through that barricaded door. Still surprises me how we actually could enter that door from the other side while I was barricading on the other side. So, huh, kind of weird. But we're done. And I'm gonna actually escape from this Dantini. And we're done with the first level. We did it. See, thank you, but you know that's the thing. We gotta we have you know, two wheels, and we're gonna need another two wheels, and we're gonna get them at this level. But the mine cart. This is another mine cart race, but I'm gonna tell you, this level was made by Satan himself. This is a really painful level. I mean, seriously, lots of beginner's traps, lots of unexpected things. I'm not even gonna commentate while riding. I need to concentrate while riding. You're gonna see soon. You're gonna see now. Just watch. To the left. Whoa! And I fucked up. You see? There is a lot of tricky stuff in there. First of all, you gotta go to the right. If you go straight, it's a beginner's trap. You're gonna die. Then you need to go hung to the left. Get to the right if you really want those damn crystals. Get a jump! There's just a lot of unexpected stuff in here that it really surprises me. Like, even for a gamer like myself, who, you know, has experience with this game, it's still a bitch to do. Let's do the Clockwork Gobbo race now to calm myself a little bit down. So, there are 16 crystals, I believe, a heart, which I really need. And a colored crystal. But here's the thing. I'm gonna go for the colored crystal. Because that, for me, is a lot more important. I'm not gonna get to the heart, even though I'm still trying to. Life sucks sometimes. But yeah, the beginning of this level shows that you're in hell, pretty much. Okay. I really want to explain what's going on with this wheel. I really want to tell you, but I cannot commentate through this while I'm trying to do it. The thing is, you're gonna go and push this what is it, crate or box or whatever. You're gonna place it on this conveyor belt. Now there are a couple. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe I'm gonna. No, I do not want to use the thingy. Yeah, you see this little TNT box in there, right? The thing is, you gotta carry the TNT box, get on the conveyor belt, and hit it on that, you know, on that box. The thing is, you don't need to do it once. You need to do it twice. So, you gotta be fast as lightning to do this. I'm not even kidding. So, if I can do it on the first try without any lag from fraps, I'm gonna be a happy man because the fourth wheel is really easy to get. But this one, it's not like if I fuck up, then it's over, then I need to redo it, but then I need to actually commit suicide and do it again. Let's try to do this. Come on, Lux, remember your controls. Okay, let's do it. Oh! What? Oh my god. That was a fail. Oh my god. I've been talking about this and then I just... No! You cannot be serious. No. You cannot be serious. I'm gonna shut up now. My face is turning red because I'm so ashamed of myself. You know what? Fuck, I'm gonna talk through it. Okay, guys. This is it. Get in the conveyor belt. Press space. That was one hit. The game is glitching now. The game is annoying. Get on there, Croc. Get the TNT. Get on the conveyor belt. Hit it with your all your mighty. Yes! Yes! Fuck yeah! Oh wait, there's still a problem. I still need to actually, Okay. Whew! Calm down. There's still a problem. Look at my health. 0 out of 0. It's not good. I gotta do something. If I fuck up now, then it's over. I need to do the level again. Okay. Seriously, this is turning out to be really bad, actually. Crap. Wait, there are two boxes. That means we're gonna do really hardcore stuff, which means that we're gonna get one hit point back. There we go, we got one back. I also know, but I don't really know if I want to do this. There's also a heart back there. But I think I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna be such a risk taker right now. I mean, seriously. I'm gonna be such a risk taker that, yeah, I'm gonna go back and get that heart. I think there's a heart up there, right? Yeah, there is one. I'm sorry, guys, that I'm not doing the thing that I need to do. But I really want, you know, to live. For fuck's sake! I'm speechless now. I'm kind of pissed, actually, now. You know, normally I'm, you know, cheerful, delightful, whatever. Now I'm kind of pissed, because I just wasted the heart that we can find. There are a couple more, yeah, sure, but two hits for me, and it's over. But, oh, there's a lot of things going on in my head, and Fraps is starting to lag for some reason. Holy shit. Okay, great, now we got the TNT part. Okay, guys, I need a little briefer for a moment. Whew. Okay, calm down, Lux. You're still in the game. You're still doing good. Let's try to do this. Okay, so in TNT, we gotta be freaking careful in here. That's the thing. You gotta actually just walk when the barrel is actually on top of you. Okay, good. Still going good. Oh, I didn't know how that didn't hit me. Oh god, another minecart. Are you serious? I cannot do another minecart. Whoa! Okay. Got lucky. Whew. I got lucky. Okay. Calm down, Lux. Calm down. You gotta entertain your people. You do not have to fail, you gotta entertain your people, that's all. I know there's a heart up there. And this time, I do not want to waste my heart. I mean, please, God, no. So, I would love to explain this to you, what this is all about, but I'm not going to. There's a track. There's a dude who goes in circles. There's a switch. You gotta hit it to actually change the tracks. And this guy is gonna go and ram the barricade up there so then we can actually have another path. Now that I've explained this, there is also a crystal that we need to get in here. That's number 3. I know where the other two are. There's one that's in a room similar like this. And there's one who is in... Oh god, there. I just remembered. There's another section of this level which is very stupid. But I need to calm myself down. I say this 100 times, but there is so much more shit coming up like this that, and I don't really don't want to die in the last level, please God, no. Okay, so there's another box with a wheel in it, and there's another dude riding his minecart, circles and all that kind of good stuff. Now, what you can do, I don't know, there are two switches. I don't know if you have to do them in the correct order, but I know the order to do it for to get that wheel. Basically, you want to get that minecart to crash into the box with the wheel in it. And then you can get the wheel, and that's the fourth wheel that we need to unlock the kart race. And I guess, actually, I want to do that kart race just to calm myself down, because holy crap, this is an annoying level. Anyway, so, yeah, you can see that now we have made sure that the box is actually on the tracks on the same level. So what we need to do now is to, you know, change the tracks of this guy. But it's a little bit more tricky to actually know where he is. Like, I'm gonna jump, and I just had a bit of luck. And I'm gonna jump. That was really perfect. You really have to anticipate where he is. Anyways, hit the switch. And I don't know, maybe you can hear a couple of booms, but he crashed through the box and he crashed through the barricade. So now we can get myself the fourth reel. And I'm glad that this is over. But I still need to finish the level. And I still need to get the crystal. So there are two more objectives for me. Okay? There are... Wait a sec. I just said get the crystal. Then I forgot to actually get the crystal in here. That, this is another derp produced by MechaRaptor from the Recu Free stuff. I mean, holy freaking crap. I forget a lot of things. I'm panicking. That's it. Anyways, the fourth crystal. It's a good thing I actually said that we need to get some crystals. Yeah, there it is. The fourth crystal is in here. God, I almost forgot it. You can see I'm panicking, but I'm still holding together. Still doing well. Even though I forget a couple of things, like I forgot the key and now I forgot this. Maybe it's because those levels are pretty complex in itself. Anyways, the last section. No, wait, not the last section. It's almost the last section. Another hovercraft stage. Now you can actually, if you really want to, you can get these boxes, but I'm only gonna go for one thing. I'm gonna go... No, you just did not do that. Come on, get it? Get the fuck out of there? Okay. Good. Okay. Oh wait, there's another thing. We still need to do this. The game gets really challenging. Okay, so there are a couple of boxes, and we need to jump from platform to platform. Seems easy. But I'm shaking right now, because these platforms are not as easy as you think they are. They are actually quite tricky. And I'm really shaking, guys. I mean, woof. You know, if I'm panicking already at that one point when I actually died twice or, you know, three times, then how about this? I mean, jump in there. See, that's the trick. I think that's the way you have to do it. You need to stomp while on that platform. But anyways, I think I got 2 hit points left. Let's save here. And now we have to do the final minecart ride for this level. I pray to God that I'm gonna make it and that I finish this level. Let's do this. Let's go to the left. Can we still go to the right? Yep, I need to go to the right. What's next? Oh, there we go. Is this it? No! Jump! Why didn't you jump? Why didn't you? Oh god, now we need to do it again. This is it, guys. This is it. If I'm not gonna make this, then fuck. Then absolutely fuck. Let's do this, but I need to shut up. I'm gonna shut up. You're not gonna hear me. Holy shit! Yes! I did it! I did it! Fuck yes! Yes! Oh my god! You do not want to know. I was sweating like a madman. Oh, you're my friend for life. Holy crap. I did it, guys. But now I'm gonna need a break. I'm sorry, but I need myself a break right now. So, like and favorite if you like the content. I hope you're gonna like this. Oh, God. I seriously hope. I need to take a breather. But anyways, like and favorite if you like the content. I just said it. Subscribe to our channel, Rake You Free, for more upcoming videos. And I'll see you next time. Peace. Woof. Seriously. Holy crap. Anyways, the first ingredient, fizz. Whoa, I just stand on that thingy? Weird. Anyways, that's the first ingredient. We're gonna get 3 more, if I'm correct. What's up, guys? It's MechaRaptor, also known as Succatus Patella, and welcome to part 7 of my Croc 2 walkthrough series. Last time, I killed the bosses of the second world, and I gave you a little introduction of the third world by making some ginger soda for this king right here. Holy crap, frats lagged a little bit. Hopefully it'll be alright. So, we're gonna do some more levels, but first, as usual, I'm gonna get some more stuff. First, I gotta check my backpack. Yeah, I only got one Clockwork Gabo. Thank you for this information, Gabo. But, yeah. Also, this door is very buggy. I don't know why. Hello. You can actually give me a blue booster. Yep, that's what I'm gonna need. And I'm also gonna need a green booster. We're getting fancy now today. We're gonna get some more, some more boosters to buy. And I need one Clockwork Gabo, but I know of myself, I'm gonna need 2. I just gotta need 2. Everything so far has been going well with the Clockwork Gabos, but I know I'm gonna fuck up sooner or later. Anyways, we're gonna do some levels I like to call the... Well, let that Gabo actually introduce it. Racing car wheels. These are the racing car wheels levels of hell. Pretty much. You're gonna see. So this is the first... level when we're gonna do in the third world. Oops, that was a boo-boo. That promise, that's a lot of promise for the next upcoming videos, I guess, or just this playthrough. Still want to do a decent run of it. That's my suggestion. Anyways, the objective of these levels is not really to save a Gabo or to you know, whatever, just to do anything to save him. No, you actually have to get some racing car wheels. That's the whole objective of the game. Right now, we're looking at a barricaded door, which is quite unique because we haven't seen this before. So we're gonna have to take another path. Oh, here's another door. But holy crap, this one has a lock on it. So it seems like we have a little bit of a dilemma, but fortunately, there is also a third door, which we can actually enter. So it's a little bit of a puzzle solving. It's not really that linear, but it isn't really that, you know, rocket science either. It's just, you gotta go from A to B, and B unlocks C, and you know, and that's that kind of stuff. So actually, you should get from A to C, but you need to go through B first. God, I make this thing a lot more complicated than it is. So, the level isn't really linear, but the objective is pretty straightforward. You need to get some racing cartwheels. I'm gonna tell you now that there are 2 wheels hidden in this level. So there are 2 that we need to get here, and there are 2 that we need to get in the other level that I'm gonna do today. So it's a little bit tricky. I'm just oh wait, holy crap! I actually forgot to get the key. That was kind of stupid. Yeah, now I'm gonna get myself even more derping herping. Jesus, I'm gonna get my ass whooped today if I'm derping like this. Anyways, Yeah, we're gonna get myself the key. Can't believe I forgot the key. I mean, I was talking about locks and level design from A to C and B to C and ABCs and whatever, and I forgot the damn key. How the hell am I supposed to advance if I didn't get the key? That was really derpish of me. I'm sorry, guys. Anyways. Yes. This is a little bit tricky. This is a little bit tricky jumping. They really expect you to, like, anticipate the jumps a little bit more. So, is this familiar from the Roger Rand and levels? You know? Hopping the platforms here and there. Anyways, the first crystal. Now we see a clockwork gobble plate. Do you need it? No. There is only 17 crystals and a heart to be found. So it's not really worth it. It's only worth it to be here just for, you know, the crystal. So yeah, I've actually done a practice run on these levels. And yeah, it's kind of tough. They're really tough. They're tough in the way that there are some things which are really new and unique. But they are also extremely annoying, difficult, or they even surprise you, you know? Even a gamer like me, I'm not really a hardcore gamer, but, you know, I have a bit of experience with this game. I'm still surprised with some things in this level. So, yeah. Anyways, this is the long walk of the bridge, and then we see a spinning wheel. And, yeah, this is the wheel that we're gonna get. There are four of them. They always stay in your inventory for some reason. It's not really that you can use them, so why is this even in your inventory? I guess it's just to keep track of how many wheels you have in case you forgot one or whatever, you know? But those four wheels are essential in order to actually complete your quest, you know, to complete the game and stuff. Okay. Blue booster, do you need it? Nope, there's only a box of five crystals and a heart hidden in there, and it's not really needed, so again we're gonna save myself some more crystals just by not using the items that we need. Okay, so you can take this path, or it can be a little cheater and can go take this path, and then you think, holy crap, there are more boxes and more stuffs and whatnot, and there's a door over there and there's another door over there with a key in it. I mean, holy crap, Lux. That's a lot of alternate paths you can take. Yeah, I'm gonna admit, it's a complex level design that we have here. Like, you can get lost in here if you really don't pay attention too much. Anyways, I'm gonna take this path. This is the path I like to take. You could do it another way. You could actually go... This is, like, I think this is anti-clockwise. You can go clockwise, you can also go anti-clockwise. And holy crap, that's the second time again that I've been hit by one of these dudes. I guess I don't really like him. So, you probably think, well, just jump in there. It's nothing that can go wrong. You know what? Since I'm being such a derp today, I'm gonna take the safe route and just do this. So now we got the second crystal. And they really want you to actually, you know, if you really want to explore, you gotta pay. I mean, there are some really nasty jumps in there. Like that one, I think you have to stomp. I tried without stomping. I hit the lava. I was sad. Yeah, some jumps, they are pretty tricky. You know, they really want you to step up your game. Like the game is stepping up its game. Anyways, another locked door. I'm gonna call it Path D or whatever. But we have to go outside and get ourselves another key. Finally, one AKO and one of these guys. So, just made that jump. Another blue booster? Yup, we're gonna need that one. We're gonna need that blue booster. There we go, there's a beginner strap! Oh! But I made it. For a crystal, that was just the only reason why we had to do it. Now look at this. Skeletons of prehistoric dinosaurs, I guess. I think it's a little bit offensive to show this to Croc, but then again, who am I? Okay, fucked up platforms. These platforms are kinda buggy. Now you probably think you could just jump over there right now. Nope, you have to time it. That's the secret. As a kid, I'm such an impatient guy that I didn't really want to do it, and I was just stomping in the lava until I get to that box. But no, you really have to take your time, plan it all out, and then hop over to the other ones. Then you can use the box And once you're going back, you can actually take those platforms, because the developers of the game think, hey, these things were actually kind of stupid, and I agree on it. But look at this, velociraptors. Yeah, dinosaurs and stuffs. And you probably think, holy crap, this is an epic fight. This is because the velociraptors don't die in one hit. Like, I hit them once, they get a bit stunned. A colored crystal. But here's the thing, I'm gonna go for the colored crystal. Because that, for me, is a lot more important. I'm not gonna get to the heart, even though I'm still trying to. Life sucks sometimes. But yeah, the beginning of this level shows that you're in hell, pretty much. Okay. I really want to explain what's going on with this wheel. I really want to tell you, but I cannot commentate through this while I'm trying to do it. The thing is, you're going to go and push this, what is it, crate or box or whatever. You're going to place it on this conveyor belt. Now, there are a couple, I don't know if you can see it. Maybe I'm going to, no, I do not want to use the thingy. Yeah, you see this little TNT box in there, right? The thing is, you got to carry the TNT box, get on the conveyor belt, and hit it on that, on that box. The thing is, you don't need to do it once. You need to do it twice. So, you gotta be fast as lightning to do this. I'm not even kidding. So, if I can do it on the first try, without any lag from fraps, I'm gonna be a happy man, because the fourth wheel is really easy to get. But this one, it's not like if I fuck up, then it's over, then I need to redo it, but then I need to actually commit suicide and do it again. Let's try to do this. Come on, Lux, remember your controls. Okay, let's do it. Oh! What? Oh my god. That was a fail. Oh my god. I've been talking about this, and then I just... No! You cannot be serious. No. You cannot be serious. I'm gonna shut up now. My face is turning red because I'm so ashamed of myself. You know what? Fuck, I'm gonna talk through it. Okay, guys. This is it. Get on the conveyor belt. Press space. That was one hit. The game is glitching now. The game is annoying. Get on there, Croc. Get the TNT. Get on the conveyor belt. Hit it with all your mighty. Yes! Yes! Fuck yeah! Oh wait, there's still a problem. I still need to actually, okay. Whew! Calm down. There's still a problem. Look at my health. 0 out of 0. It's not good. I gotta do something. If I fuck up now, then it's over. I need to do the level again. Okay. Seriously, this is turning out to be really bad, actually. Crap. Wait, there are two boxes. That means we're gonna do really hardcore stuff, which means that we're gonna get one hit point back. There we go, we got one back. I also know, but I don't really know if I want to do this. There's also a heart back there, but I think I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna be such a risk taker right now. I mean, seriously, I'm gonna be such a risk taker that, yeah, I'm gonna go back and get that heart. I think there's a heart up there, right? Yeah, there is one. I'm sorry, guys, that I'm not doing the thing that I need to do, but I really want, you know, to live. For fuck's sake! I'm speechless now. I'm kind of pissed, actually, now. You know, normally I'm, you know, cheerful, delightful, whatever. Now I'm kind of pissed, because I just wasted the heart that we can find. There are a couple more, yeah, sure, but two hits for me, and it's over. But, there's a lot of things going on in my head, and Fraps is starting to lag for some reason. Holy shit. Okay, great, now we got the TNT part. Okay, guys, I need a little briefer for a moment. Whew. Okay, calm down, Lux. And then they go into primal rage mode. And again, you have to hit him twice very fast. So I'm losing a lot of hit points, but this is just to show you all that the enemies are a bit of a derp. In the way that they're actually stronger. And oh my god, this is the third time already I get hit by one of these guys. Give me the key. Ugh, annoying. Anyways, you see those crystals? That's a pretty bitchy place to get them, huh? Yeah, you really need to, like, if you really want those crystals, you gotta do some tricky jumping, you know, from platform to platform. Kind of annoying, but, you know, there is one crawler crystal up there, so yeah, we need to do it. That's the fourth one. Just one more to go, and we can get ourselves the Golden Gabo obstacle course. The first Golden Gabo of this third world. Pretty excited to actually snatch it, if it actually works, because I think at this rate, the way I'm playing right now, yeah, I don't think it's gonna really help a whole lot. Because god damn it, I'm losing a lot of hit points here and there. It's not good, because I still have another world to do. Damn it. I'm not gonna get 100 crystals out of this level, so I don't get full life. So, huh. Okay, I'm gonna take it easy. There we go. Take your time, just like in the ice world. Just take my time and everything will be alright. So we got the key. Can open this door now. So whoopity freaking do. And then another long bridge. And there's another wheel there. So we're gonna get our second wheel. And there's another crystal up there, hidden. Not really hidden, you can see it from far away. And we got ourselves an obstacle course. I hope I will actually manage to do this obstacle course correctly. Like, without derping much, because I am really scared. Anyways, this fireball is a bitch. You gotta wait for it. You just run! This one is pretty easy. Just walk over it when you have to. This one is a little bit annoying, because there's a curve in there. This one is the very last one. You can easily just whoop, and then just get... Yes! Get the gabo. Number 11. I'm happy. Whew. At least that went right. Okay. So, where are we now? Holy crap, we're actually through that barricaded door. Still surprises me how we actually could enter that door from the other side while I was barricading on the other side. So, huh. Kind of weird. But we're done. And I'm gonna actually escape from this Dantini. And we're done with the first level. We did it. See, thank you, but you know, that's the thing. We gotta we have two wheels, and we're gonna need another two wheels, and we're gonna get them at this level. But the minecart. This is another minecart race, but I'm gonna tell you, this level was made by Satan himself. This is a really painful level. I mean, seriously, lots of beginner's traps, lots of unexpected things. I'm not even going to commentate while riding. I need to concentrate while riding. You're going to see soon. You're going to see now. Just watch. To the left. Whoa! And I fucked up. You see? There is a lot of tricky stuff in there. First of all, you got to go to the right. If you go straight, it's a beginner's trap. You're going to die. Then you need to go hung to the left. Get to the right if you really want those damn crystals. Get a jump! There's just a lot of unexpected stuff in here that it really surprises me. Like, even for a gamer like myself who, you know, has experience with this game, it's still a bitch to do. Let's do the Clockwork Gabo race now to calm myself a little bit down. So there are 16 crystals, I believe. A heart, which I really need. And you're still in the game. You're still doing good. Let's try to do this. Okay. Some TNT. We gotta be freaking careful in here. That's the thing. You gotta actually just walk when the barrel is actually on top of you. Okay. Good. Still going good. Oh, I didn't know how that didn't hit me. Oh God, another minecart. Are you serious? I cannot do another minecart. Whoa! Okay. Got lucky. Got lucky. Whew. Oh, I got lucky. Okay. Calm down, Lux. Calm down. You gotta entertain your people. You do not have to fail, you gotta entertain your people, that's all. I know there's a heart up there. And this time, I do not want to waste my heart. I mean, please, God, no. So, I would love to explain this to you, what this is all about, but I'm not going to. There's a track, there's a dude who goes in circles, there's a switch, you gotta hit it to actually change the tracks. And this guy is gonna go and ram the barricade up there so then we can actually have another path. Now that I've explained this, there is also a crystal that we need to get in here. That's number three. I know where the other two are. There's one that's in a room similar like this. And there's one who is in. Oh god, there. I just remembered. There's another section of this level which is very stupid. But I need to calm myself down. I say this 100 times, but there is so much more shit coming up like this that, and I don't really don't want to die in the last level, please God, no. Okay, so there's another box with a wheel in it, and there's another dude riding his minecart, circles and all that kind of good stuff. Now, what you can do, I don't know. There are two switches. I don't know if you have to do them in the correct order, but I know the order to do it for to get that wheel. Basically, you want to get that minecart to crash into the box with the wheel in it, and then you can get the wheel, and that's the fourth wheel that we need to unlock the kart race. And I guess actually I want to do that kart race just to calm myself down because holy crap, this is an annoying level. Anyway, so. Yeah, you can see that now we have made sure that the box is actually on the tracks on the same level. So what we need to do now is to, you know, change the tracks of this guy. But it's a little bit more tricky to actually know where he is. Like I'm gonna jump, and I just had a bit of luck. And I'm gonna jump. That was really perfect. You really have to anticipate where he is. Anyways, hit the switch. And I don't know, maybe you can hear a couple of booms, but he crashed through the box and he crashed through the barricade. So now we can get myself the fourth wheel. And I'm glad that this is over. But I still need to finish the level. And I still need to get the crystal. So there are two more objectives for me. Okay? Wait a sec. I just said get the crystal. Then I forgot to actually get the crystal in here. That this is another derp produced by MechaRaptor from the Rec You Free stuff. I mean, holy freaking crap. I forget a lot of things. I'm panicking. That's it. Anyways, the fourth crystal. It's a good thing I actually said that we need to get some crystals. Yeah, there it is. The fourth crystal is in here. God, I almost forgot it. You can see I'm panicking, but I'm still holding together. Still doing well, even though I forget a couple of things, like I forgot the key and now I forgot this. Maybe it's because those levels are pretty complex in itself.